Hello and welcome to PDFsupply.com. Today we're going to be testing a 9070ALG320. It's an analog output. I have it here. And let me first describe what I have going on here. First, I have these modules in a IC697CHS750 5-slot rack. I have, from left to right, a power supply, IC697PWR711 power supply. CPU is an IC697CPX772, and of course the IC697ALG320, and for a later test only I have an ALG230, nothing to worry about right now. But what I've done is, in Prophecy Machine Edition, I've configured what you see here in the software so that the ALG320 is in slot number 2, and I've configured it to give me a voltage reading. So I just first pay attention to what I have here. This is actually set up so I can do either a voltage test, this terminal strip, or a milliamp test. So this is 0 to 10 volts, 4 to 20 milliamp. I have jumpers on 1 and 3, 9 and 11, 17 and 19, 25 and 27. And then for my milliamp test coming up soon, you'll see I have 24 volts connected to 34 and 36. That's screws 34 and 36. Okay. So what I typically do to test this device is I'll go into my analog output table, which you'll find in your navigator bar under reference view tables, and then subcategory default tables. So analog output. We're going to be testing channels 1, 2, 3, and 4. So what I usually do is I'll put in the maximum value, 32,000, in each channel, see if I get a full reading, full 10 volts. That's typically like 9.99 volts to a meter. It's nothing to be concerned about, but that's usually what you want to see. So let me get a meter where you can see it. And get a couple readings here. All right. So for voltage, I'm going to be getting this on terminals 3 and 5. And I have a solid 10 volts. Now I'm going to hold this on there, and I'm going to remove the 32,000 from address 10001. Analog address 001. So I'm going to put a 0 in there and hit enter, and it should drop down to a nominal value, or in this case 0, which is perfect. The reason I do that is because if the unit has failed, if the channel has failed, that is, it would still read 32,000. They usually fail at full value or at partial value. Now I'm going to work my way to number 2. Same thing, I'm going to zero it out. 3. Now here I'm going to do something a little different just to show you something that you could do. As you know, I have a value in here of 32,000, so I'll cut that in half, 16,000. And I should get half the reading, 5 volts. And I'll cut that in half, 8,000. I'll get half that reading, which would be 2.5, and so on. And I'll go ahead and zero that out. That's something that you could do to all channels. Okay. 0. That's something that you could do to all the channels. I just put it on that one so we wouldn't have to do that on each one in the effort to save some time. So now we're going to test milliamp. I'm going to stop my processor. Go into the configuration of the ALG320, the 4 channels. And I'm going to switch it to 4 to 20 milliamp, and it'll change my output and the output location. And once I've configured that, you need to go back in and clear controller and I/O fault table, because you've made a change, the CPU's used to something else, and you're going to trigger a fault if you don't clear those two. So you have to go into target, go into clear, online commands, clear, controller fault table, IO fault table. And then I'm going to go ahead and download and run that. I just want to stress it's very important that you do clear those, because you are going to create a hindrance for yourself if you don't. And we're just downloading hardware configuration and logic when it asks us. Nothing else. We don't want to write any of this to permanent flash memory. This is just a simple test. And then once we're back in run mode, we're going to do the same procedure. Okay, and we're in run mode. So go back to analog output. Put in my values of 32,000, all four channels. Okay. Now I'm going to switch my meter to read milliamps in DC. So if you have a meter like this, this selects AC or DC. You want DC. And it's set up for milliamp, and I have it over to the far left-hand side, so I have a more detailed reading, more decimals. So, I'm going to go to terminal points 2 and 4, and the reading I'm looking for is, 20 milliamps, 0.21 is fine. For this one, we'll cut it in half. Reading of 12, 13 is normal, so that's a value of 16,000. I'm going to go to a value of 8,000. Value of 8 or 9 is normal. So that's what I do there. I'm going to go ahead and zero it out. I recommend that you do that on every channel, but for this test, we're back to terminals 10 and 12, locations 10 and 12, screws 10 and 12, 21 milliamp, that's fine. So I'm going to go ahead and zero that out, and it drops. Again, I like to zero it out because if it does fail, it's going to fail at full value, the full 20 milliamps, typically. In output number 3, I'm looking for terminals 18 and 20. All right, there we go. And then we dropped it. And the last one is number 4, 26 and 28. 21 milliamp, and we're going to drop it to zero, and it dropped. So, everything's fine with that one. That's what you should expect to see. So, I've had situations where the OK light isn't on, but it comes on once it's configured. So, it's not something that you always go by with the OK light, although you should typically have it on. And then these channels that we just went over, voltage 0 to 10 volts, milliamps, you should get readings just like the ones that I saw. You should be at 9.99 to 10 volts. And like I said, you should keep cutting those values in half to make sure that it's able to read that different voltage, or put out that different voltage rather. And if you do have a problem with that, this is something that we typically look at here. We do fix and repair, and we offer exchange programs, same day shipping. We have new and remanufactured products. So if something that you do need, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.